Hello from London, where we're set for a rainy day after a grey morning, as the cooler months start to settle in like they mean business. But I will sing of thy power, yea, I will sing aloud of thy mercy in the morning, for thou hast been my defence and refuge in the day of my trouble. Psalm 59, verse 16. It's Monday, the 12th of October, in the year of our Lord, 2020, and it's time to sit back and start your week right. I'm Mark Sidwell, and this is Mark's Almanac, bringing you 5 minutes of civilised calm, recorded in East London, just as the capital starts to wake up. When we stepped ashore, we saw fine green trees, streams everywhere, and different kinds of fruit. Soon many of the islanders gathered round us. I could see that they were people who would be more easily converted to our holy faith by love than by coercion, and wishing them to look on us with friendship, I gave some of them red bonnets and glass beads which they hung round their necks, and many other things of small value, of which they were so delighted and so eager to please us that we could not believe it. Later they swam out to the boats to bring us parrots and balls of cotton thread and darts and many other things, exchanging them for such objects as glass beads and hawk bells. They took anything and gave willingly whatever they had. That's from Christopher Columbus's account of his first landing in the New World on this day in 1492. On this day in 1915, the nurse Edith Cavell was shot by a German firing squad. Her Anglican faith drove her tireless work during World War I to help the sick and wounded on both sides of the brutal conflict. And the night before her execution, which was immediately condemned around the world, Cavell said, "Patriotism is not enough. I must have no hatred or bitterness toward anyone." The Church of England remembers her today in its calendar of saints. Today we also remember Elizabeth Fry, who died this day in 1845, whose Quaker faith drove her to champion penal reform with the support of Queen Victoria. Fry was nicknamed the Angel of Prisons, but her tireless work also included creating homeless shelters, campaigning to end the slave trade, and in 1840, opening a training school for nurses, which inspired Florence Nightingale to take a team of Fry's nurses to the Crimean War. Here's a poem. All my friends are finding new beliefs, by Christian Wiman. All my friends are finding new beliefs. This one converts to Catholicism and this one to trees. In a highly literary and hitherto religiously indifferent Jew, God womps on like a genetic generator. Paleo, keto, zone, South Beach, bourbon. Exercise regimens so extreme she merges with machine. One man marries a woman 20 years younger, and twice in one brunch uses the word verdant. Another's brick-fisted belligerence gentles into dementia, and one, after a decade of finical feints and teases like a sandpiper at the edge of the sea, decides to die. Priesthoods and beasthoods, sombers and glees, high-styled renunciations and avocations of dirt, sobrieties, societies, pilgrimages to the very bowels of being. All my friends are finding new beliefs, and I am finding it harder and harder to keep track of the new gods and the new loves, and the old gods and the old loves. and the days have daggers and the mirrors motives, and the planets turning faster and faster in the blackness, and my nights and my doubts and my friends, my beautiful, credible friends. That's almost all for today. I'll be back next week. Don't forget you can sign up for emails with show notes and links whenever a new episode goes live at marksalmanac.substack.com. And remember, that's Mark with a C. And if you need some music to wake you up for the week ahead, how about something from Britain's twin country stars, Ward Thomas, whose new album Imagine launched at the weekend? Their old song, Carry You Home. If you need a light, I'll help you find a reason to believe. Until next week, stay civilized, keep calm, and please keep washing your hands. Have a lovely day.